I've never really cared about sports, so recently I wondered, what if I made a machine that plays sports for me? The goal with this machine is to hit repeatable home runs. But first I want to be clear, this machine was something I first saw on Mythbusters when I was 9, and I wanted to build it ever since. But instead of using a sword, I'm gonna use a baseball bat. What it looks like they did on Mythbusters was use a pneumatic cylinder to pull a chain, which was wrapped around a post which swung the sword. And essentially they converted linear motion into rotational motion. Also, what I'm going to do that I noticed is not use a valve, but rather plumb the cylinder straight into the compressor and then restrain the bat with a rope and quick release. I also want to try something I haven't seen done before, which is to draw a vacuum on the exhaust side of the cylinder. Inside this cylinder is a piston. When you apply compressed air to the intake, it pushes the piston, and drawing a vacuum on the exhaust side will do two things. One, it'll basically increase the pressure on the compressed air side. And two, normally if you actuate this with a valve, the piston will be pushing a bunch of air out this fitting, kind of like blowing through a straw. And a vacuum is essentially nothing, so therefore the piston won't have to push anything out of its way, aka very little resistance. So after studying lots of screenshots and designing, I got to work. I'm about to make a hinge out of this DOM pipe and some round bar. This pipe is allowed to telescope because it doesn't have a weld, it's seamless. Now that I've got the frame tacked together, I can go around and do all the finish welds. The inside of this flange bearing is like 10/1000ths of an inch smaller than the outside diameter of this pipe, so I'm gonna have to sand a bit off to make it fit in. Normally I would use push to connect fittings for this, but since they're super expensive for this size bore, I figured why not just use normal quick connect fittings for like a normal air hose. At this point, I took it to the backyard for testing, and then I realized how violently unstable this thing is. So I added some outriggers and about 300 pounds of sand. I realized I should add a counterweight to the arm, but I just wanted to solve it with brute force first. After the second test, it was still a bit rowdy, so I did add a counterweight to the arm, but not until after I tried to add some more power with a garage door torsion spring. need to add more weight. Okay, so that last test, I just hit a 200-foot drive, and I want to hit over a 300-foot fence. And the garage door torsion spring didn't really add anything, so that went out the window, and I added another pneumatic cylinder. So after all of the testing,
three, two, one.
It's time to see if it'll hit a home run. All right, we're here at the sportsball venue, the kind where they traverse bases, I'm told. That was so dumb. Anyways, we're gotta unload about 1,000 pounds a year out of the truck, and then we'll get running. This field doesn't have a fence. And so to represent our goal of hitting 300-foot drives, this will be our visual aid.
Yeehaw.
Yeehaw! This is really far. Is this right? Is this 50 feet? This has to be. This is a lot farther than I thought.
A lot farther than I thought.
A lot farther than I.
I apologize for the audio, but I have to run the compressor while I run the vacuum pump to be able to run the machine. So the maple bat wasn't giving us enough distance, so we're gonna try out this aluminum bat. We'll take every ounce of energy we can.
How you feeling right about now?
I'm feeling optimistic. I think there's things we can dial in, like the new bat, to get this thing where we want it.
3, 2, 1.
Woo!
Yes. Oh yeah. We're getting
yes.
There.
That's
We're
pretty close.
There. Yes. Pretty close. Here's the flag here. I mean, I'm not mad. That was pretty close. It was probably like within 50 feet of this. Not bad.
Hold on, I'm getting a report from the field. After review, it was determined the 300-foot marker was in fact measured incorrectly. The home run machine did hit several drives over 300 feet. The machine hit consistent home runs. This is Angus Longmire, reporting for Sportsball Network.
It turns out we were dropping balls right past the fence, one after another. This one's just for fun. This is a lacrosse ball. It's solid rubber, so it should go for miles.
We got a car coming. 3, 2, 1.
I thought I was gonna hit that car. That was so close.
Yeah!
want to see more videos of crazy machines like this that I've built, you can click the playlist right here. That's it for this one, guys. See you next time.